I was going to a night school.
What kind of night school stays open till 4 in the morning? A night school for tramps?
Emma, please, you're gonna wake up the whole neighborhood.
Ma, I called you and I told you I was taking a course in acting.
You told me? Never mind what you told me. Let me tell you something. Where were you?
A night school I can understand. 9 or 10 I can understand. But 3 in the morning? That's no night school.
A night school for tramps?
The school for actors, Ma!
Bums and tramps!
I had to stay later to study my part like homework.
Now, you don't get homework on the first day. On the first day, you meet your teachers, you get your books, you don't come home till 4 in the morning. Where were you?
It's not like normal high school. Don't you believe me?
All right, I believe you. If you don't want to tell me, I will leave.
Okay.
Now go to bed. So it's time to get up.
All right. Good night, Pa. Good night, Mom.
Good night, Tatum.
And no more acting school, David.
What? No, I've got to. They're depending on me.
I said no more acting school. Tell them, Mars.
David, you heard what Mama said.
That's how you tell
them. David, what do you need this acting school for, huh? You're worrying Mama for nothing.
But Mom, the man in charge says I'm very good. He picks me out of about 40 guys.
David, you have a job. Do a good job. You're going to be a druggist, a good one. And you'll get married, be a good husband, a good father, a good trip to 4 in the morning. You don't have to be.
But Mom, listen.
Tell him, Morris!
Good night, David.
Good night, Mom. Good night, Mom.
Are you hungry?
No, I'm okay.
What'd you eat today?
Meat, Mom. Okay, good night.
He's a good boy, Emma.
Did I say he wasn't a good boy? I know he's a good boy. He's mine. But he's still a boy. He has to be told.
I know.
If we could afford to send him to pharmacy school.
I know.
All right, go to bed. And in the morning, you talk to him. Acting. Imagine if something got into him.
You know. I once saw Jacob Adler in a play on 2nd Avenue by William Shakespeare. Gold. Pure gold.
I'll talk to him.
Are there any more actresses in the play? I thought you could introduce me.
I wouldn't know who does what first.
Hello, Miss B? Laura? It's Dave. Dave Kollowitz from Foreman Machines. Yeah, your lunch date. I'm sorry, but I'm gonna have to call off our date. Well, I got a job in the play, and they called a rehearsal this afternoon, so I'm not gonna be able to make it. It starts tomorrow night, I think. You're more than welcome to be my guest. A banquet of what? I didn't know your friend was a hat salesman. It's kind of neat.
Marvin, are you here yet?
No.
Maybe I should make you a part.
No, it's okay.
Oh, no, please don't worry. Sit down.
I don't care.
Maybe a game will be
that way. I never played that game. I just stopped to say hi.
And if you didn't say hello, I would leave my supper.
That would be very unfortunate.
What kind of job does he have that he's here but they pay? Any calls?
No. Hello?
Who? Molly's hats? So what do you want, Kaplan? Maybe new shuttle? Why didn't you call earlier? I was out, but my boy was here. He wasn't. Where was he? All right, I'll be over to look at it later. Don't be a little woman, Kaplan. I said, I'll come. Maybe a bit earlier. So, good afternoon.
I'm sorry I was late, Mr. Foreman. It was only about 15 minutes.
David, 15 minutes or 15 hours? On time is on time.
Yes, Mr. Foreman, I know. I'm sorry.
David, if you're supposed to open, you're not here. Someone calls with a big order, an emergency.
Uh-huh.
You don't pick up? They call someone else. What are you sweeping first thing in the morning? Are we not going to make the appointment?
No, Mr. Foreman. I must be thinking of something else. Oh, Mr. Foreman?
Yes?
Can I borrow $10 till payday?
I didn't hear.
Can I borrow $10 till payday?
David, what does a boy like you need $10 for? Food you have, clothes you've got, car fare you also have. You need $10 for what, Tootsie Rolls? David, are you in some sort of troubles?
No, Mr. Foreman, it's no trouble.
If you're in trouble, David, tell your father. Always tell your father.
Well, it's no trouble. The reason I didn't tell my father is because it's... for his birthday.
For your father's birthday?
Yeah, I wanted to buy him something. A new prayer shawl.
Oh. You're a good boy, David. Prayer shawl. You're a good boy. For that, you have the right to lend. I can help you out, too. I'll get it for you wholesale.
No, Mr. Foreman, actually, I have one all picked out. It's ready to go.
David, about prayer shawls, I know a bit more than you.
No, Mr. Foreman, actually, it's my present to my father.
It's still your present, but I'll help you out a bit. I'll get it when I go to lunch.
Oh, Mr. Foreman, I forgot my lunch.
Your father made you a lunch and you forgot to take it?
Well, no, I didn't forget exactly. My father took it by mistake.
Your father took your lunch?
By mistake.
And why didn't you take his lunch?
Well, because he doesn't have lunch. He doesn't eat lunch.
Your father doesn't eat lunch.
He normally eats lunch out.
So why didn't he take your lunch?
It was a strange mistake. See, he brought home dress samples and put them next to my lunch. And he must have grabbed my lunch on the way out instead of the dress samples. I guess he's nervous on account of his birthday.
Father's nervous about his birthday? All right, I'll get you a corned beef sandwich when I go to lunch.
No, Mr. Foreman, see, since my father took my lunch, I made an appointment for lunch.
You have an appointment? The $14.50 a week delivery boy had an appointment. Ah, mega.
$10, I think. I asked everybody.
David, I have $10. I was supposed to buy a dress, but I can get it another time.
Well, no, Jean, I can't take money from you.
You're not taking it. It's a loan.
Well, still, I...
David, can't... please. I want you to. When I see you on stage, I'll know that's my suit. Really. I want you to.
Gee, Juana, thanks. You're a great girl. You know that? I'll pay you back right after payday.
There's no hurry, really.
Okay, I guess I'll pay you half this payday and half next payday.
Whenever you want.
Okay, I guess I'll pay you $3 a week for 3 weeks, and I'll give you that last dollar on the fourth week, so it'll take about a month, but you'll get your money.
David, I'm really happy I could help, honest. So, do you know your part yet? Is it very big?
Well, it's not super big, but I've been studying a lot on the subway and at home. I stayed up very late last night trying to remember it all. So.
Is it a lot?
Well, I'm only in 2 short scenes, but it's an important part, kind of a playboy.
Oh, do you think I can come and watch?
Yeah, I guess so, if you want to.
You'll be wonderful. I just know it. A playboy.
Yeah.
All right, what are we having?
Oh, gosh, I haven't even looked at the menu.
Yeah.
I'll just take a Coke.
A Coke.
Yeah, another Coke.
Just 2 Cokes for the table.
That's all.
All right. So, what kind of playboy are you in the play, David? Do you kiss the leading lady or anything like that?
Well, yes, in one scene I do kiss the leading lady.
Oh, you do? Well, is she nice looking?
Yeah.
Very nice looking?
Oh, good. I'd say so.
Well, she must be pretty old to be the leading lady, right?
No, she's not so old.
David, is there something you want to tell me?
No, nothing I want to tell you.
David, you know that we said we would always be honest with each other.
I know that.
Well, is there someone else?
No, nothing like that.
Well, what is it then?
It's something like that, but not exactly.
Well, is it the actress?
Well, in a way.
Well, do you like her?
I don't hate her.
And how does she feel about you?
She doesn't hate me either.
Oh, so the feeling's mutual.
What can I do? You want me to be honest, don't you? That's life.
Absolutely. Of course I do.
There's also this bookkeeper.
Another one?
No! You think I am girl crazy?
Well, have you kissed her?
Which one? No! Neither, not yet. I mean, no, not at all. You want your $10 back?
Of course not. I better get going.
Well, gee, Wanda, I hope you're not sore or anything.
Of course not. What is there to be sore about?
Wanda, I want you to know that even though I may be attracted to other girls, you're still the only girl I want to... talk to those other girls about too. I mean, you're great.
Thank you.
You're a great listener, and I just.
You forgot to pay your tab.
To be or not to be? That is the question, ladies and gentlemen. And tonight you will see a trick never tried before. To meet the telephone. Disappear from the...
Can I help you, sir? David, what is this?
Nothing, Mr. Foreman. I'd better go oil that machine.
Nothing, Mr. Foreman.
The boy puts on a tuxedo and a mustache in the middle of the room. Nothing must form it. All right, so it's nothing. Tell me, David, maybe I don't understand so good. I'm not 100% American, as you know. Is it normal for an American boy to put on a tuxedo and mustache in the middle of work? Is it the Yankee holiday or something?
Well, no, Mr. Foreman, I was just practicing. I'm gonna be an actor!
An actor? An actor, like on the stage? David, what you do at night is your own business, but here you have to act like a person. No foolishness with the tuxedo and mustache. Here I don't need a Greta Garbo.
Yes, Mr. Foreman.
Oh, David, I got the present for your father.
What?
Prayer shawl for your father's birthday.
Oh, thanks.
Oh, $2.50. $4 prayer shawl. I'll take it off your week's pay.
Thanks, Mr. Foreman.
An actor I am for Albert. David, will this be alright for fancy actors such as yourself to make a delivery to the very moment?
Yeah, of course. I'll go right out the paperwork.
So, no, please put your tuxedo on, beautiful mustache, and deliver the machine.
You really won't? Oh, and Mr. Foreman, I'm actually going to have to leave about an hour early tonight.
Again, why?
Well, it's my father's birthday, and...
Again with your father's birthday. Who is he? George Washington? Maybe we should close the shop for his birthday.
Okay, it's just that tomorrow night's the show, and I've got to rehearse today. It's just really important to me.
What about your father's birthday?
Well, I wanted to do the show and surprise him on his birthday, but...
All right. I'm all mixed up with the acting and the birthday and the mustache and... just deliver the machine and don't bother coming back today.
Well, thank you, Mr. Foreman.
Oh, you can get the receipt and bring it again tomorrow.
Okay. Sounds good.
David, huh? Where are you going?
To deliver
the... You forgot your father's present?
Wow. That would have been bad on his birthday. Bad news, he'd been so mad. So, alright, well, I'll go take...
time, David. If you want to keep this job, no more half-day's work. You hear me, Mr. Actor?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Good.
and put that godforsaken box down, not on the set pipe! Get rid of it! Wait, well, that's my tuxedo. I'll need it for the show.
Trust Pike, he'll take good care of it. Now, let's drive from your entrance, Don.
Remember, you're a dashing, elegant young man. Shall we try it? Okay, dashing and elegant? Okay, all right, I can see you. No, no, don't leave me. You're a gentleman, not a kangaroo. Walk, saunter, be debonair. My boy, the idea is to have rhythm. Count if you have to. You can count.
Yeah, I can count.
How high?
Pretty darn high.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Not with me! By yourself!
Shall I go back?
S'il vous plaît. Yes, please. Are you? Or aren't you? Mr. Marlowe, if you want me to change something, then tell me. And if you want me to go, I'll go. But I don't think you should yell at me like that.
Well, I'm encouraged. You're beginning to sound human.
If you want me to do it again.
No! No, I've had enough for today. I'm sick. I'm nauseous.
Okay. Look, Mr. Marlowe, I know I wasn't very good, but didn't
you? You know that, and I know that. Now our job is to keep that little secret from the audience.